I know that we were all saddened to learn the untimely passing of our friend and colleague, the gentleman from the 32nd Legislative District, Anthony M. DeLuca. As is our custom, we will now take a few moments for memorial service here in the chamber of the House to reflect upon his service to the House of Representatives and to the Commonwealth. We will now consider the condolence resolution for Representative DeLuca. Sergeant Arms, please close the doors of the House. Chief Clerk will please read the resolution.
Whereas the House of Representatives of Pennsylvania wishes to honor the memory of the Honorable Anthony M. DeLuca, a member of the House of Representatives of Pennsylvania, who passed away at the age of 85 on October 9, 2022. And whereas the son of the late Lawrence and Catherine DeLuca, Representative DeLuca was the beloved husband of Constance DeLuca for 66 years prior to her passing. A graduate of Westinghouse High School and the Community College of Allegheny County, he operated DeLuca's Meat Market with his father and brother and served Penn Hills Borough as a council member and deputy mayor. Lauded as the longest serving member of the House of Representatives of Pennsylvania, Representative DeLuca served the 32nd Legislative District from 1983 until his passing and was a co-founder and longtime chair of the State Legislative Italian American Caucus. Passionate about improving accountability measures for medical professionals, he worked tirelessly to increase access for the Children's Health Insurance Program and other programs to assist uninsured Pennsylvanians as minority chair of the House Insurance Committee for more than 20 years. To his great credit, Representative DeLuca was inducted into the Westinghouse High School Hall of Fame, and he was the recipient of the Leadership Award from the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society of Pennsylvania and the Elected Official Award from the Allegheny County Library Association. A beloved family member and respected legislator, he generously gave of his heart and time to enhance the quality of life of his family and community, and his loss will be felt by the many individuals who knew, admired, and loved him. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the House of Representatives of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania proclaim with enduring sorrow the passing of the Honorable Anthony M. DeLuca and extend heartfelt condolences to his sons, Larry and Anthony, daughters, Debbie Brinker and Michelle Joyce, 9 grandchildren, 3 great-grandchildren, and many other family members, friends, and colleagues. And be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution, sponsored by Representatives Brian Cutler, Carrie A. Benninghoff, Joanna McClinton, Austin A. Davis, Tina Pickett, Sarah Enamorato, Brandon J. Markosik, Arian Abney, Jessica Benham, Martel Covington, Daniel Deasy, Dan Frankel, Emily Kincaid, Anita Astorino Kulik, Summer Lee, Robert F. Matzi, Dan Miller, and Nick Piscitano on October 11th, 2022, be transmitted to the family of the Honorable Anthony M. DeLuca.
Those in favor of the adoption of the resolution will rise as a mark of respect for our former colleague. Guests will please also rise as able. The resolution has been unanimously adopted. Members and guests, you may be seated. The Sergeant Arms may open the doors of the House for the Judiciary Committee to come in upon their arrival. Our chamber feels very different today as we are missing one of its most reliable, recognizable, and I would offer best dressed faces. Representative DeLuca served the 32nd District for nearly 4 decades. For every member of this chamber, he was here long before each of us. And I think we always felt like he would be here long after we were all gone. I'd like to recognize the wonderful group of family and friends who've made the trip to be with us here today. We are blessed to be joined by Tony's children, his sons Anthony and Lawrence DeLuca, his daughters Michelle Joyce and Deborah Brinker, his son-in-laws John Bud Joyce and Christopher Brinker, grandchildren Nicholas, Anthony, and Ashley DeLuca, Joseph Joyce, Emily Brinker, Olivia Adams, and her husband Gabe Adams. Thank you very much for coming today, and we're very sorry for your loss. We are also joined by two of Representative DeLuca's dear friends, Ken and Ruth Ann LaDrew, and our former colleagues, Representative Joe Markosik and Bill Kortz, who we introduced previously. I'm sure that Tony's looking on today, with Connie by his side, filled with so much pride in all of you. We are honored that you have joined us here today in a place that meant so much to our friend. Representative DeLuca always made it clear what his priorities were. In a business where it's sometimes difficult to find out exactly where someone stands on an issue, Tony was a straight shooter. If it didn't benefit the people of his district, he wasn't interested. It's why I think he was a key part of our chamber and a cherished leader in his own community. He was a tireless advocate for senior citizens and their families. And as someone who beat cancer twice, he never relented in his own fight to help those facing their own battles with their own diseases. He was a constant voice for detection and awareness. He introduced legislation and fought to increase funding for research and treatments. Representative DeLuca recognized most issues do not choose a party, and there wasn't time to waste over arguing who was going to get credit for doing something. People needed help, and we could do something about it. For more than 20 years, Representative DeLuca serves as the Democratic Chair of the Insurance Committee, a position where I had the privilege of working directly with him and his staff on recent years as we developed our state-based insurance exchange and reinsurance program. And whether it was that bill or the Children's Health Insurance Program or the Life Insurance Database Act, Representative DeLuca didn't care about the interests of one party or another. All he ever cared about was people. That's what made him successful, what meant so much to those of us fortunate enough to serve with him. Our chamber mourns today, but we will honor him by carrying his spirit with us all in the work that we continue to do. I will share with the family when we break. I have a photo that I want to credit Representative Harkins with taking. It was the last photo of Representative DeLuca and I on the floor, and it's one of my favorites because what you don't see in the photo was I had to gavel him down shortly before we were back there having a good time. And his love of the institution, I can honestly tell you I've never seen more compassion and passion from an individual, both for not just the issues, but for us as a legislative body. And it meant so much to me to have him as a friend and a mentor, and I certainly will continue to miss him. We'll recognize Leader Benninghoff.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Though I may be the leader of the Republican caucus, if there's anyone who I thought exemplified the ability to be bipartisan or at times even nonpartisan, it was Tony. And if that is part of the legacy that helps in your own grief, I hope it does. I've also admired Tony's courage to write to wear suits that are a lot more exciting than mine. Of course, a guy my size to wear an orange suit would probably look like a pumpkin or a lemon or that baby blue one. I don't think I've worn one like that since my junior prom, which ended up in a very short date. So I'll stay with basic, boring black and blue. But I did want to share on a personal note. You know, sadly, we get so busy in these jobs, maybe sometimes our own grandeur, that we forget to just realize that people sitting on the other side of the aisle are people and representing people just like us. And it's almost like a sporting event. Tony's and my friendship probably got better and stronger, sadly, due to tragedies, and that is family exposure to cancer. And Tony reached out to me very quickly on my daughter's situation and was one of the probably the most faithful members of the Cancer Caucus, something our caucus and the Democrat caucus at one time had three members with children with brain cancer, all of which resulted in losses. And Tony became a faithful member to the Cancer Caucus, one because of his own curiosity. While Tony was a couple years older than I was always impressed by the fact that he always wanted to continue to learn and know more. And he was very passionate about that. And so out of all tragedies or losses or things that we don't necessarily want to have happen, there is positive things. And I would tell you that though we lose the person, we don't really lose who they are, because they live on through the rest of us. And that's kind of the neat thing about this chamber. This chamber has people come and go and come and go, and we all kind of build on each other. And if we're smart enough and or at least keen to what's going on around us, we can all learn from someone else. I tell my children, meet as many people as you can in life. Some will touch you for a minute. Some will be your friend for a lifetime. But every one of them will affect your life. And I just wanted to say personally, thank you for all the time that you had to give up with Tony being here. A very dedicated person. Some would have used his illness as a reason to leave, retire, not be here as often. Not Tony. And that gusto, that moxie, that desire to continue to be as strong of a servant and as a representative when he first got desired to the last remaining weeks here is really something we should all emulate. And I'm honored by that. And I'll close with the fact I personally, as an individual, as a man, and not just as a legislator, feel that my life has been enhanced by him and by his friendship. So God bless you. The grief is painful, but sometimes I think the pain is because we feel that they're going to be forgotten. Those luminous suits, that big smile, and that good baritone voice, especially when he did get a little excited, will be forever remembered in the hearts of many. Thank you, and God bless you and your family. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you, Mr. Leader. At this time, we'll recognize Democratic Leader McClinton.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Tony DeLuca, where can I even begin? Aside from what has already been noted about his unrivaled style, there's so much more to say about him. I will admit I did look for a salmon-colored suit this morning. But I said, it is also October, and we weren't here for the breast cancer event last week, so I better stick with pink. But Tony would tell me, that's not pink, Joanna, that's salmon. He was a friend, a mentor, a leader, an advocate, and a fighter for what was right. Chairman DeLuca represented the very best of this institution. His approach to legislating and leading transcended generations. He set an example for all of us that each and every person deserves to be treated with respect and compassion. Over the past few weeks, so many of our colleagues from across the state, and as you've heard this morning from across the aisle, have shared personal stories about their interactions with Tony. His mentorship, his guidance, his advice, his unwavering commitment to looking out for the good people back home that sent him here 40 years ago. His willingness to work across the aisle, not just sometimes, but often and frequently. Most importantly, you have heard from neighbors and from friends and constituents who shared their Representative DeLuca stories, or as he was affectionately called, Uncle Tony, or Cousin Tony, and how he made a difference in the lives of their very own and their community. People were his passion. Tony never forgot names, even after decades. He would never leave his office before every single person who had stopped by had a chance to speak with him directly. His annual picnic was so well loved that families would plan their personal vacations around it and show up early in the morning to pick out their spots. So many attended early that Tony started serving breakfast and lunch. Finally, constituents cherished the birthday cards that Tony designed every year. Some would call his office very excited because he remembered their birthday, and others to say thanks because it was the only card that they received. Tony was a true public servant. Everyone knew how hard he worked for the people of Penn Hills and Verona, and his other communities. But there's no denying how much he enjoyed the camaraderie up here in Harrisburg among his colleagues in this institution. He was welcoming for all members who would stop by, and how many of us enjoyed his luncheons? Two hands. And he was a great conversationalist when spending time downtown. And of course, as we heard, he's a very proud Italian American, and of course, started and was the long-term chairman of the Pennsylvania Legislative American Italian Caucus. He credited his upbringing with instilling in him the value of hard work. He was provided lessons to so many of us that never faded. He was a fighter here in Harrisburg and personally conquered lymphoma twice. He and his wife, your lovely mother and grandmother, they had their very own challenges, but those challenges didn't stop Tony ever. In fact, they drove him to do more. As was said, he was a champion for so many patients, for so many healthcare consumers. He was an outspoken advocate for cancer awareness, for early detection, and he pushed for changes in the law so that there would be more funding for research in cancer and improved treatment and procedures for those getting care after being diagnosed. Representative DeLuca served in this chamber a very long time, longer than any member who is here today, and before some members were even on this planet. But his length of service is not what made him so impactful. It wasn't just 40 years. It was his friendship, it was his collegiality, it was his resolve in the face of adversity, it was his commitment to fighting for what was right above all else. It was the fact that he demonstrated resilience. I remember my very first time meeting Chairman DeLuca coming here in 2015 after a special election. We were in the middle of a challenge with the budget. I'll just call it a challenge. And I recall everybody standing up, and I used to sit in the back in those days, not long ago, in the middle of the row there. And I said, well, who are we clapping for? And a neighbor told me, we're clapping for Chairman Tony DeLuca. He's been sick, but he's back today. And that's when I first started to learn about his resilience firsthand, on how there weren't problems that would have kept me personally home with a sick leave notice, but he would come. He would be here for even tough votes and difficult decisions when he could have easily remained in his district, because all of us admired him and respected him. And I can say, on my journey in this current role as the first woman to ever be leader in our caucus, Chairman Tony DeLuca was there for me. He was by my side. He was encouraging me. He would call me, and he'll tell you he'd call a spade, because many people won't do it. They'll tell someone else about your spade, but Chairman DeLuca would say, Joanna, baby, why didn't you tell me first? And I say, oh, I'm sorry, Chairman. You know, I'm busy, I'm overwhelmed, I'm stressed. He said, I get it, I get it. You got to make your moves, but you should have called me. I said, oh, I'm sorry. A lesson once learned, but he taught it to me in a way that was with grace, was with patience. And I'll tell you the best thing that all of us will remember, besides recently being gaveled down by the speaker, the thing that all of us will remember is that this year, in the middle of a debate on a voting bill, going back and forth about how will this bill go, what will happen, Chairman DeLuca came to the front of the House and stood up to speak, and he said, you know what? You Republicans are always saying there are irregularities with the elections. You've been in power 25 of the last 30 years. Maybe it is rigged. We will forever remember Chairman Tony DeLuca. Thank you. God bless you. We appreciate you providing so much space, so much time for this journey. He has impacted and changed all of our lives, and we will never be the same. And we thank you for the sacrifice that it took for him to come back and forth from Penn Hills in sickness and in health. We are forever grateful to you. God bless you and comfort your hearts.
Thank you, Madam Leader. I remember both of those occurrences. I only picked the one that that I found the most humor in, but that was also a very, very Tony thing to do, which is why we loved him, honestly. He was more than happy to share his thoughts. He was a zealous advocate, and he was very thorough anytime that he took on a task. With that, we'll recognize Chairman Pickett for some comments.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. That's hard to meet, Joanna, but I will try to add to it for Tony today. And Mr. Speaker, I do remember that day also, and I think perhaps even though you stated the rules clearly to Tony, he may have had a bit of a win there. I'm not sure. Okay. I do thank you, Mr. Speaker. I join my House colleagues in mourning this great loss of Representative Tony DeLuca. Tony was a dedicated public servant who spent his long career improving the lives of his constituents and the people of Pennsylvania. As Democratic chairman of the House Insurance Committee, as Republican chair of the committee, I got to know Tony well and appreciated his ability to cross the aisle and work together on important issues. He brought years of experience and knowledge to our committee. First and foremost, Tony was honest and open. We all knew exactly where he stood on legislation that was under consideration. Tony always had the best interests of Pennsylvania consumers in mind. He faithfully judged a bill on its merits, but was willing to seek compromise and a path forward to advance good policy. I will miss Tony's professional and friendly approach to the business of the day. His passing is a great loss for the committee and for the consumers who were always his focus. As a side note, I will also miss our friendly competition as to who was wearing the most colorful and fashionable blazer for the meeting. As you might expect, Tony won every time. Godspeed, Tony, and rest in peace. Thanks for your many years of outstanding service to your constituents and to this House of Representatives. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you, Madam Chair. We will now recognize Representative Austin Davis for his comments.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, for allowing me the opportunity to convey my deep respect and condolences and admiration for Representative Tony DeLuca. My sincere condolences to his family, his friends, the people of Penn Hills and Pennsylvania's 35th Legislative District. Over his nearly 40 years as a representative, Tony made an impact by being a champion for improving the lives of others and all Pennsylvanians, particularly seniors and families. This is best encompassed as his work as the Democratic chairman of the Pennsylvania House Insurance Committee. Earlier this year, as his vice chairman on that insurance committee, we worked together to make health insurance even more accessible by creating the easy enrollment option here in Pennsylvania. To make sure we connected uninsured Pennsylvanians with Penny when they filed their state income taxes. As many of you know, Tony believed in serving as a state representative was his full-time job and his only job. He was a true elder statesman, a compassionate individual who truly believed in this body and the mission of public service. Obviously, Tony and I come from very different generations. But when I first got to the House as a legislator, he gave me the opportunity to serve as the Democratic Vice Chairman of the House Insurance Committee in my first term. That's an example of his mentorship and leadership in the House to make sure that every legislator had the opportunity to succeed. Perhaps the highest mark of who he was that in his decades of service, he never became cynical and always remembered where he came from and who he represented, the good folks in Penn Hills and Allegheny County in southwestern Pennsylvania. Tony's dedication to fairness, compassion, and bipartisanship made him a great leader and a mentor to many folks here in Harrisburg and at home. He was a character and truly one of a kind, somebody I will never forget and who has left an invaluable mark on this House and on me personally. Thank you for sharing Tony with us for all those years. Thank you.
Chair, thanks, gentlemen. And recognize the gentleman representative, Dan Miller.
My voice is not doing Tony justice today. And we've heard so many great things from our leader, and we obviously respect the majority leader's words and speaker as well. I sat next to Tony for about 7-8 years back there. He was the first person I actually talked to on the floor of the House. We had different opinions. We ended up at one point, he found out that I was Italian. We spent an hour and a half in his office. And I learned so much about what it was being Italian to him in Pittsburgh. Long stories, a lot of laughs, really fun. We've also been there for other conversations, and I want to let you know that you all were so close to him here. When his wife passed, spent some time with Tony, and he was telling me about this fantastic romance love story, right? So many good things. And I said, you know, I said, oh, sound, you know, fantastic, Tony. And he said to me, he goes, Danny, he said, I wasn't home enough. She had to carry a lot of weight. He wished that he had been home a little more. I wanted to let you know that. His eyes got a little thing when we talked about it. But we had so much fun. He cared so much about his district and being up here with it. I could tell you, for all of us who have served with it, we thank you again for sharing him. He made a difference not only for how the state works and how the Commonwealth takes care of people, but he made a difference to so many of us who called him friends. Thank you very much for coming up and sharing him with us.
Chair, thanks. The gentleman recognizes the gentleman, Representative Frankel.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and certainly want to welcome and offer our condolences to all his friends and family who are with us here today. I rise to honor the life of our friend, Tony DeLuca, who died on October 9th. Everything Tony did was big. He introduced more bills than anybody, 85 this session. The senior fair his office hosted just days before his death had 400 people come through. His local donut shop knew him because he never had an event without donuts and would routinely place orders for 20 or 25 dozen of them at a time. He used to organize 4 or 5 bus trips to Harrisburg every year. He designed and sent birthday cards to every single constituent over the age of 62 every year. He never forgot a name, and he never failed to return a call. And as you heard, his picnic was legendary, and if you were running for statewide office, you dared not miss that picnic. Ultimately, Tony made the people around him feel safe and cared for. His staff shared with me that they had a running joke about the size of Tony's family, because it seemed that half of the people who walked into his district office started by announcing that they were Tony's cousin. So much of this job we have is one of staff management, and I always take notice when members are able to keep turnover low, making sure their workers feel valued and respected. Tony's staff had more than 50 years of service between them, and I'd like to acknowledge them now and thank them for their dedication to the people of the 32nd District. Liza King, Janet Loalbo, Constance Cunningham, Louis Leone, Alan Cohen, his executive director of the Insurance Committee, Linda Dolphy, William George Jr., and Joseph Keller. And if they're here, would you please stand and be recognized? As Democratic chairman of the Insurance Committee, Tony and I worked closely over the years to increase access to health care for all. I served on the Insurance Committee for 10 years, and during that time, Tony served both as the Majority Chair and Minority Chair. This was prior to Representative Chair Pickett, but his relationship with the prior chair, Representative Mukosey, was legendary. I mean, when you talked about bipartisanship, when you talked about friendship, that radiated through that committee, it was really an extraordinary opportunity to work together to get things done for the Commonwealth. And you could hardly tell, you know, who was the majority chair any of the time because of that kind of relationship. And it sounds to me that that relationship and that example has continued today under the chairmanship of Representative Tina Pickett. Tony found himself confronting health issues as a patient and as the husband of a patient over the years, and he never failed to think about how much worse these challenges are for Pennsylvanians without good health insurance. This week, we expect to see the passage of Senate Bill 225, legislation that he advocated for passionately over many years. This bill will streamline the process of prior authorization, speeding it up and increasing transparency for patients. When I cast my vote for that bill, I will picture Tony right alongside of us with a bright suit and a big smile. Tony's presence on this House floor will be sorely missed, but we can carry on many of his values. We can fight for the little guy, stay connected to our constituents, try to transcend partisanship when we have the opportunity to improve the lives of Pennsylvanians. Be kind to our workers and workers everywhere, and we can be fearless when it comes to fashion. Goodbye, my friend. Thank you so much.
Chair thanks the gentleman and recognizes the gentleman, Representative Freeman, for comments.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and thank you for the opportunity to reflect on our good friend, Tony DeLuca. Like the others who came before me to speak, my condolences to the family and friends of Tony. You've had a great loss, and we have lost a great member in that process. I had the privilege of knowing Tony for 40 years. He was a colleague and a friend, but we actually got elected together in 1982. I was 26 years old, he was in his mid-40s. But we were good friends, and we shared many outlooks on consumer protection and workers' rights and all the things that Tony cared about. Our class was a big class. We had 22 Democrats, 13 Republican members. It was one of the larger classes that came in that period of time. But Tony distinguished himself always as a good and decent man. And for anyone to be remembered for that is truly one of the greatest accolades any human being can have. He never forgot where he came from. He never forgot his roots. He was a very good representative, very dedicated, and a dedicated and hardworking chairman, too, of the Insurance Committee. He really put his heart and soul into that work. And as Representative Frankel pointed out, he was aided in that effort by a good staff who admired and loved their boss. Tony truly reflected his district, the people of his district. He was proud of the communities that made up his district, and he really cared about their concerns and their aspirations and always tried to represent them as best he could in this chamber and throughout our work. Throughout his career, he was a champion of consumer protection. I remember from the first day I met him, that was one of his main aims, to look out for the needs and protections of consumers, but also to fight for greater access to health care and health care coverage, to look out for the needs and interests of our senior citizens, to fight for the needs and interests of working families, and always, ever foremost in his thoughts, was to look out for the little guy. Tony understood so well that in many respects, our job as a state representative really calls upon us to give voice to the aspirations, the hopes, the dreams, the needs of the little guy. Someone who doesn't have some powerful interest group to look out for their concerns. We're their voice. Tony knew that. He understood that. and he worked to make sure their voice was heard here in Harrisburg. Tony was a fighter. He was frank in his manner, but deep down he had a very warm and caring demeanor, which we all came to know. His family, his friends, his constituents can all be proud of the kind of service he gave their district. He will be missed.
Chair, thanks, gentlemen. The closing prayer this morning will be offered by Democratic leader Joanna McClinton. Members and guests, please rise as able.
Thank you, Lord, for this day you have made. We are rejoicing and we are glad, even with heavy hearts, as we will sorely miss Chairman Tony DeLuca. Lord, we thank you because he showed us what it means to live life in a way that shows how we should look out for our brothers. You told us over and over again in your word that we should love our neighbors as ourselves, that we should deny ourselves and pick up our cross and follow you daily. And certainly he exhibited that throughout all of his years, not only serving us, but the work he did even locally before coming to Harrisburg. Father, we thank you, Lord, because we know from understanding in your word that life is a journey and our days here are numbered. It says in Psalms that life is but a vapor. It is here today and can be gone in the same day. But we thank you for the breath in our bodies. We thank you for understanding that when we leave this place, we certainly will have the privilege to be in your presence. In your presence, there's fullness of joy and there are pleasures forevermore. We pray as he takes his eternal rest that we will find comfort in the way he lived his life and that we will be challenged to be able to have less of what we say we need and give more to other people. Give more love, give more care, give more concern, show more compassion. Let us not just be fighting all the time, but Lord, even the work you give us with our gifts and our hands, let us do it in a way that shows servitude and gratitude in every decision we make. We thank you so very much for his life, and we pray that you will comfort his family, that you'd encourage their hearts, that you lift the pain and the burden from the serious losses in the last year in their lives. In his staff, Lord, we pray that you lift their heads. You told us in Psalms, you are the lifter of our head, that you provide us refuge and strength, and you are our present help in the time of trouble. So give them everything they need. Comfort them, encourage them, wrap your arms of love around them. Let them know they will make it. Let them know that they can rejoice even with this pain, because we understand the journey, that our days here are numbered, but the key is making the days count. We thank you and we give you the glory. We ask all these blessings in Jesus' name. Amen.